After a hotly contested start to the series, what's in store for us here? It's game two of the ALDS between the Boston Red Sox and the Cleveland Indians. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, an important ballgame coming up here in game two.
Yeah, and remember that this is just a five-game series, so getting that first win under your belt is especially important right here. If they can get a second win now, they could really give themselves a good chance to move on.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 Cleveland Indians.
And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one. More from the guys as this one goes along, but first, let's get a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Boston Red Sox, as John Farrell's guys will line up like this. And look there at the starting pitcher charged with facing these guys, as his numbers are on your screen. Xander Bogaerts heads for the batter's box, and we are just about ready for some evening baseball. And a cold strike on the game's first pitch as we bring you this one here tonight.
And you know, these guys come in here off of a loss in game one. And maybe that's to be expected. Remember, these guys are the underdogs in this series, but if they have any designs on winning this series, that makes this game two such an important game. You'd hate to go home down two games to nothing already. And knowing that you'd need to take three in a row to win the series, it just doesn't happen very often.
Defensively, the Indians will line up this way. Jackie Bradley Jr. is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one. Grounded to third. Throw gets him, two down. Mookie Betts gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on. On the ground down the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So a rather pedestrian start to the top half of the first. Red Sox nothing. Tribe coming to bat. It's Major League. Now we'll look at the starting lineup for the Indians here. They'll tee it up against the ever-improving right-hander Rick Porcello. And in the field, the Red Sox will look like this behind him. Francisco Lindor will stand in, coming off a great performance in the Game 1 victory.
And he really is the X factor in this lineup. If he can stay hot, we're going to have a good chance of pulling this thing out.
And that's a base hit. So a little first pitch swing in there as he's on to kick off the inning.
Boy, I'll tell you, these are the scary ones for a pitcher. This is going to give you a pretty good angle right here because this ball is hit so hard and it's just about right at him. I mean, there's no time to do anything out there. And he's pretty lucky that one didn't get him because he would have taken his head off.
Into the box now, Jason Kipnis. As he gets a good curveball here to start the at-bat, it's strike one.
A little bit of hang time there to that curveball. I don't think that's exactly where he's going to want to throw that pitch going forward. It worked out right there, but he better find a little extra snap on that pitch in the future.
Driven nicely into the gap, and it's going to get down and should be extra bases. Around third and being waved on home. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
Well, we've seen a couple really good swings here early on. And that's a good one there as this ball is going to plug the gap for two bases and give his guys the early 1-0 lead.
Into the box, Michael Brantley. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one.
Yeah, and you've got to be careful that you don't go up there helping them out, especially if you get that feeling that they're trying to work around you.
Yep.
Swing and a miss, and he's in the hole 0-2 now. As a look, now the pitch. Swung on and taken the opposite way out toward deep left center. And he will get there to make the running catch as that ball hung up just a little bit too long. And he'll get into third here on the flyout, so he's 90 feet away here with one gone.
So a double and a fly ball move a man to third now with one away. Now if they could just get another fly ball, it would likely net him a run.
Come set, now the pitch. Mike Napoli stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. One out and a runner on third. Slow curveball like a balloon and he couldn't hold back. It's strike two.
And now this is where you can be just a little bit more selective as a pitcher. You're looking for the strikeout. You certainly don't have to throw a strike in either of the next two pitches. So you got to see if you can get him to chase.
Throw from shallow right will get him at first, but the run will come in to score.
Yeah, and unless he was bored on his own down there at third, they were using that contact play where you're told wherever and whenever the ball's hit, you're off and running. You're not even paying attention to what's going on. You've got to go. They love to play an aggressive style on the bases, and it gets them a run right there.
Standing in now, Carlos Santana. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Two out, nobody on. Now he swings and hits this ball on the ground. And that will be a base hit here for Santana.
Boy, you talk about a ball having eyes. First off, he's fortunate to get this one by the pitcher. It's not hit especially hard, but you'll see it get past second base where neither middle infielder can track it down. It'll make its way into center field.
In now, Lonnie Chisenhall, as he gets under the first pitch and sends a fly ball out to left center. Number 40 is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the shot. David Ortiz makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second. Now the pitch. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
And that's where you're going to have to be with that fastball. Like a lot of power guys, this guy is a pull hitter. so he has a lot of trouble getting out in front of that hard stuff. Kind of comes around that pitch when it's up and away like that.
And this is going to be a foul ball. Now the 1-2 home to Ortiz. To two balls and two strikes now. And a good battle brewing as Ortiz lays off. It's full 3-2.
Yeah, maybe a little frustrated after that last call didn't go his way. Now he's got to make sure he doesn't lose him here on 3-2.
And the throw on to first will take care of him, so he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away. Hanley Ramirez digs in, ready for his first plate appearance. That's hit sharply past the mound and on into center field for a one-out single.
Yeah, really not a bad pitch when you look at it. This is at the knees with some movement. He just uses the center of the diamond and checks in here with a base hit.
Into the box now, Dustin Pedroia. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. Runners on first with one down. In there, strike two.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch, but you got to do it. You can't give up that inside corner. This guy will eat you alive.
And Pedroia swings through that one as he's set down on strikes for the second out. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And standing in now, the versatile Pablo Sandoval. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing in one.
And after that call, you know he's got to be turning around to say something like, hey, you know what? This guy doesn't need any help.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. 1-2 is the changeup had him out in front there. And this is fouled back and out of play. Chopper foul. Two out with the man at first. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called and the inning is over. One left for the Red Sox. They trail things here 2-0. Jose Ramirez strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. And this is going to be a foul ball. Goes with the 0-2 here as this is on the ground to third. Throw on to first and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away. Roberto Perez steps in now. Now a swing and here's another chance down there at third. Throw gets him at first and I'll tell you what, they don't come much better than what you saw right there. Number 30 stands in. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. This is foul for the first strike. And the pitch. Here's a swing, and he saws him off here as this ball's popped into the air. Throw won't be in time as he reaches it first. Francisco Lindor will stand in. He singled to lead off the home first. And prior to the first pitch, he'll look to first. And a dive, but he's back. Goes goes the other way as this is hit high and deep out to straightaway left. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Number 40 will get his first opportunity now.
Leading off for the Red Sox, left fielder, number 40.
And this is fouled back and out of play. And now pitch on the way. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
And sometimes you got to cut down a little stride against a guy who's throwing this hard.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is smoked to right, and I don't think this one's coming back. No chance. It's gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His first homer so far in the series, and the Red Sox are on the board. It's now 2-1.
This is where these guys can be so dangerous. They've got power all throughout the lineup. When the number eight hitter's taking you deep, you know there's no easy outs.
Into the box, Brian Holliday. And there's a swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch to start him out. Nothing in one.
Yeah, same pitch here from the home run ball, but this one's in a much better spot down at the knees.
Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. And a swing, and a ball hit foul heading for the seats. So another foul ball here, and it remains 1-2. Just inside, not by much. It's 2-2.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out. Xander Bogaerts. We'll get a second shot now. He grounded out to start the ball game. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at bat. Normally this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
Hit hard, but foul. Fouled straight back. One out, nobody on. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two. Jackie Bradley Jr. stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Swing and a ground ball to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. And thanks to the home run, the Red Sox draw a step closer. We play 2.5. It's the Indians 2 and the Red Sox 1. Jason Kipnis digs into the box in the bottom of inning number 3. First pitch of the inning is a fly ball out to straightaway left. Number 40 is there to make the catch, and it's one pitch, one gone here in the bottom of the third. Michael Brantley is into the box for his second appearance. 0-for-1 with a flyout. And the first pitch is chopped foul right at home plate at strike one. Swing and a line drive to center field. And Brantley will reach. He's got a base hit.
I think he was looking for a fastball there. I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see. And he was right on that.
Foul back. Set, now the pitch. Line hard, deep into left. Number 40 is there, and he has it for the out. Carlos Santana will dig in. He singled his first time around. He's ready, now the pitch. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. Throw on to Ortiz, and that'll retire the side. One left for the Tribe. They lead it 2-1. Mookie Betts will step in to lead things off here for the Red Sox. Big Poppy on deck to follow. In there, strike one. Strike two called on the inner half, 0-2 now. And he misses there, 1-2.
A classic strikeout pitch there on 0-2. It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate to lay off.
Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. So the base is empty here with one away, and here's the still dangerous left-handed bat of David Ortiz. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. That's wide, 2-0.
That's the importance of having veterans on your ball club. Now, a young guy, you might have swung at both of those first two pitches.
2-1 pitch is a fastball swung on and missed, 2-2. One run, two hits, and no errors for the Red Sox to this point. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. What's the call here?
I still don't think I'd throw him a strike. Good chance that he's going to be chasing something, expand the zone, so you make him show you that he can hold back.
Hanley Ramirez stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Starts things here with a changeup for a called strike. Slider, and that's in there for strike two.
Not only is he close to going through the heart of this lineup, he may even strike out the side.
And Ramirez able to hold off on that one, but he still trails in the count. It's 1-2. And Ronnie Chisenhall is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Right fielder, number 8.
Here's the pitch. And he gets under this one and, in fact, breaks his bat as this one's popped up. And he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first down. Jose Ramirez stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. The pitch. And a two-seam fastball there, but this is chopped fouled at the plate for strike one. Now here it comes. Good swing there, but this is fouled off to the right side. And this ball hit sharply toward the first base coaching box. It's a foul ball. Another 0-2 home. Fouled straight back. Another 0-2 coming. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Well, he might have just said, look, you're going to have to take this one because you ain't fouling that one off.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number 2. Roberto Perez stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
And I think now you're starting to get the sense that he's put that first inning behind him, and he looks a lot more comfortable out there now.
Setting him up inside as he swings and misses for strike two. And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now.
Well, he's had a lot of guys swinging at pitches out of the strike zone early on, so it's a great idea to go ahead and bounce one there on 0-2.
And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up inside for the third strike in the inning. Dustin Pedroia will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so against a guy who's definitely in a groove out there.
Yeah, he struck out the side his last time through, and they've got to do something to get this guy out of the role that he's been on.
He got the high fastball there, and he popped it straight up. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. Pablo Sandoval in now. He went down looking at his first trip to the plate. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Another good job of getting ahead here. He just seems so locked in right now.
Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. Throw on to first is in time to get Sandoval, and there are two gone now.
Number 40
steps into the box. And a strike called at the letters. Looked high to me, but it's nothing and one. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Number 30 will step in now to lead off the inning as his guys look to maybe break the rut they've been stuck in.
Yeah, and after that first inning, it's been all zero since. And once he kind of got settled into that groove, he's been a difficult nut to crack.
I'll hit sharply as this is pulled into right. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
So far, he's throwing a lot of fastballs here early in the count. And these guys have picked up on that, so they're just going up there looking for the hard stuff, and they've been all over.
Francisco Lindor will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far. Now a move over to first, and he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Pause, now the pitch, and they'll have another here as this is into right field for a base hit, and that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Textbook start to the inning right there. Back-to-back hits have him in a good position to maybe stretch out this one-run lead.
Jason Kipnis steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. From the stretch. What a great diving catch, and this could be a double play.
Wow, that's just a great play right there. Let's put the ISO on him out there at second base. You see the first step quickness. No wasted movement whatsoever. Then he's completely airborne as he takes away a certain base hit.
Standing in now, Michael Brantley. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder. There's one. On to Ortiz. Not in time, so they just get the one. Mike Napoli digs in, and we'll see what he can do here with two on and two out here in the fifth. Now a swing and a fly ball. And no one can corral that one. Base hit. And that'll score the runner from third as they'll open up a 3-1 lead. Carlos Santana will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. A couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. Now a swing and a fly ball. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul. So a missed opportunity there. Comes set. Now the pitch. Now a fastball is lifted into the air to shallow center. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Brian Holliday will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far as he's yielded just two hits through the first five.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had him off balance all game.
Now here's the pitch. And a good swing there on 1-0, but this is in the air out to right field. And the sixth inning opens with a flyout, one away.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was a solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2.
Boy, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look for.
One run, two hits, and no errors for the Red Sox to this point. And yet another foul ball here as this finds the seats and the count will remain at 0-2. In time to first and there are two away. Jackie Bradley Jr. will stand in again. A couple of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one and it's strike one. And this is fouled back and out of play. Lifted down the line and right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. Inside as he might be trying to set him up here 1-2.
Well, he watched that one all the way in and it looked like he almost gave up on it. He's pretty lucky that wasn't called strike three.
And a swing as he pulls this one into right. And Chisenhall will make the catch and the side is retired. Lonnie Chisenhall gets things started here in the sixth for the hometown team. Now here's the pitch. Now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to deep right field. And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one.
Well, he is definitely doing his part out there. You see his line so far. He's keeping his guys in the ball game. He's just not getting any help offensively.
Here it comes. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now the pitch. Oof, and it's safe to say he doesn't look all that comfortable up there. 0-2 now.
Yeah, not his best effort right there. Luckily, he's still got another strike to turn things around.
Pedroia now at second. And the off-balance throw will be too late, so a good effort that time, but it's an infield single.
He just did everything right here on the mound. He made the good pitch. He got his guy to hit the ball on the ground. But baseball's just a little bit like life. You know, things don't always go your way. This is going to be an infield single as he reaches here with one away.
Roberto Perez will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. And now Boston's bullpen springs into action. A left-hander and a right-hander begin to throw. 1-0. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. We're in the sixth inning here in a 3-1 ball game. Fouled back. He waits. Now the pitch. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Here's a ball swung on and lofted in the air out toward right center. Calling for it is Betts, and Mookie's got it for the second out.
Well, the only good news that comes out of this at-bat is that he stayed out of the double play. Other than that, this at-bat really didn't achieve a whole lot.
Has a look, now the pitch. Number 30 stands in as he swings and misses for strike one. Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2. Ball swung on and hit high down the line in left, but it'll get back in among the crowd, so the count holds at 0-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. There's a bouncing ball now back up the middle, and for the third time tonight, he's got himself a base hit.
And now another base runner for him to contend with now. And as we bring up his line, you can see that's an even 10 hits against him so far. And you have to wonder how much longer they're going to let him stay out there.
He's ready now, the pitch. Now a ball grounded foul over toward the coaching box. Comes set, now the pitch. Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2.
Oh, and you know what? That might be the best curveball we've seen all night out of him, and he picked a good time to throw it.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
Yeah, he's still sticking with that fastball, but you start to get the sense that it's flattening out just a little bit. That could be a warning sign.
And this is swung on and missed, though he will need to do a little housekeeping at first. And the throw is in time. It's a strikeout, and the play at first goes 2-3 for good measure as the inning is over. Mookie Betts is set to get us started for the late innings of this one. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Grounded fouled off to the right side. Pitch on the way, and this is going to be a foul ball. Now some movement in the Tribe bullpen as a right-hander starts to loosen up, and his 0-2 is bounced on the ground to third. On to first, and a big out to start the seventh, one gone. David Ortiz will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ball game so far. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike, nothing in one. You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Way outside. 1-2. Now a ball sliced out of play down the left field line. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground, but foul. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. A little low, it's 2-2.
Just like the guy he faced before this, another long at bat here. He's had to make 13 pitches just to these last two hitters.
And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out.
He's been able to get out when he needs him with that curveball. And there you see what his pitch breakdown has been so far.
He'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. And Ramirez can't get that one as he swings and misses for strike two.
Boy, I'll tell you, to be down 0-2 against a guy like this with the stuff he's got tonight, no.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Fernando Abad will get the ball now as he'll take over on the mound to start the home seventh. Jason Kipnis gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. A dive, and oh, he can't hang on. And he is in there.
Left fielder
Michael Brantley stands in. Might try to improve in this at-bat after grounding into a fielder choice his last time up. From the belt, the pitch. Now he squares and gets one down. And the throw is late at first, so they can't get anybody out.
And you wonder here if the problem is that the second baseman is a little late in getting over to the bag. I'm not sure if that's it or not, but either way, if a guy's giving himself up, you have to get the out. I mean, that's just really poor fundamentals.
He's ready. Now the pitch. Mike Napoli is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Oh, has him looking silly here. It's 0-2. Where do you think they go from here?
Maybe double up and go back to another off-speed pitch. Didn't handle that one all too well.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. Carlos Santana will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. Betts is there. Two down.
And that's actually a lot tougher play than it looks out there in right field. You know, sometimes off of a right-hander's bat, that ball can kind of curl away from you, but he stays right with it to put it away.
And this is swung on and hit on the ground at Pedroia at second. And a gorgeous flip to second, and with that, the side is retired. Dustin Pedroia will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on. That's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. He takes it to the opposite field, high and deep to left. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out. Number 40 will stand in again as we take you back to earlier in the ballgame. This one swing here has been the entire offense to this point, as this home run accounted for the only run they've tallied so far. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. Jose Ramirez digs in to lead off the bottom of the eighth inning. Pitch on the way. Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. And he watches a called strike at the knees. No balls and two strikes. Now a ball hit foul off to the right and up into the crowd. And a good two-strike swing here as he's been fighting off some tough pitches, but the count will remain at 0-2. Here's the pitch. And he goes up the ladder on him, but he lays off 1-2. Here's Bogaerts, the young shortstop. And a good throw gets him, one gone. Roberto Perez will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Here's a bouncing ball now up the middle, and it's going to sneak its way into center field for a one-out base hit.
Yeah, he hit a good pitch there. This leads toward the outside part of the plate, but he stays with it all the way. Uses the big part of the field and gets himself a base hit.
In now, number 30. as he swings at the first pitch and lifts a fly ball out to left field. Number 40 is there, and he'll bring this one in. Francisco Lindor, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. And he will get there as he had to cover a lot of ground to make that play. And that ends the inning. Brian Holliday will stand in to start off the ninth here, with his guys in danger of going down two games to none if they can't rally. Andrew Miller is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a cold strike.
Oh, and you wonder if maybe he decided beforehand just to take a pitch up there first. Too bad for him, because that thing was right down Broadway.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and there's the first out here in the ninth. Xander Bogaerts will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. And a strike to even the count, 1-1.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
Swung on and hit deep to left center. This one has a chance. And this one is gone, a home run. It's a solo shot for Xander Bogaerts, his first homer here in the series, and the Red Sox have cut this to a 3-2 ball game. Into the box now, Jackie Bradley Jr. As he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. Maybe too much break on the slider, 2-1.
When you start that pitch off the edge, most guys know well enough to lay off. You've got to start it on the edge if you want him to chase.
Number 30 is there, and there are two men gone now. Mookie Betts will stand in now, and he's been kept quiet out of the number three hole, hitless in his three at-bats so far. And a fastball from Miller as he jumps ahead, nothing and one. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. That slowly hit to the right side. Throw on to first will be in time, and the Indians have held serve here at home. They take games one and two of this series as this one is over.
Well, he did serve up the home run here to make this one a little bit more interesting. But in the end, he does get the job done, and he nails down the save.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score.